to sleep. Maybe by next Christmas you'll have a home. Merry Christmas, my angel.
Successful year. So, after all that hard work, it's time to start preparations for next Christmas. What in the name of Sam Hill is that?
Little Buddy Diapers.
His name is Buddy. He must have snuck into your sack at the orphanage. What do we do?
So, Santa had a decision to make. Fortunately, when it comes to babies, Santa's a pushover. So Buddy stayed with an older elf who had always wanted a child, but had been so committed to building toys, he had forgotten to settle down. Santa? Yes, I raised Buddy. I was his adopted father. Though a Buddy grew twice as fast, he wasn't any different from the other children.
Not too fast, Buddy.
I mean, not really.
Now, before we learn how to build the latest in extreme graphic chipset processors, let's recite the code of the elves, shall we? Number one.
Treat every day like Christmas.
Number two.
There's room for everyone on the nice list.
Number three.
The best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
And one day, when Buddy was old enough, I made him my own personal apprentice.
Never been in this room before.
Well, I think it's time you start your tinker training.
Santa's sleigh.
If you're gonna help me make it fly.
I thought the magical reindeer made the sleigh fly.
And where did the reindeer get their magic from?
Christmas spirit. Everybody knows that.
Well, as silly as it sounds, a lot of people down south don't believe in Santa Claus.
What? Who do they think puts all their toys under the tree?
Well, there's a rumor floating around that the parents do it.
That's ridiculous. I mean, parents couldn't do that all in one night. What about Santa's cookies? I suppose parents eat them too?
Yeah, I know. I know. And every year, less and less people believe in Santa Claus. I mean, we have a real energy crisis on our hands.
Oh.
I mean, just see how low the clausometer is.
That's shocking.
That's why I came up with this little beauty in the 60s.
What is it?
It's a Kringle 3000. A 500 reindeer power jet turbine engine. Without it, the sleigh couldn't get more than a few feet off the ground. Well, looks like we got a short on the thermocoupler. You want to give me a hand with that?
You want me to help?
As much as Buddy was accepted by his family and friends, there were a few drawbacks to being a human in an elf's world.
Okay.
Hey, Ming Ming. I'm gonna be a little bit short on today's quota.
It's all right, buddy. Just how many Etch-a-Sketches did you get finished? Come on, buddy, how many?
I made, 85.
85? That puts you 915 off the pace.
Why don't you just say it? I'm the worst toy maker in the world. I'm a cotton-headed ninny muggins.
No, buddy, you're not a cotton-headed ninny muggins. We all just have different talents, that's all.
Seems like everyone else has the same talents except for me.
You have lots of talents. Special talents, in fact. Like, special talents?
You changed batteries in the smoke detector?
You sure did. Triple A's. And in 6 months, you'll have to check them again. Won't he?
Mm-hmm. And you're the only baritone in the elf choir. You bring us down a whole octave.
In a good way.
See, buddy, you're not a cotton-headed ninny muggins. You're just special.
And so, Buddy was sent where the special elves work.
Hey, Foom Foom, I hate to do this to you, but think you can help me pick up the slack on those Etch-a-Sketches?
No problem.
I appreciate it. Buddy is killing me. I already got Lum Lum and Choo Choo pulling doubles.
It's quick thinking yesterday with that special talents thing.
I feel bad for the guy. Just hope he doesn't get wise.
Well, if he hasn't figured out he's a human by now, I don't think he ever will. If he hasn't figured out he's a human by now, I don't think he ever will.
I think they're too small.
You're just special.
You don't look so good, buddy. Are you okay?
I'll be okay. I just need a glass of water.
Ah! Buddy!
Are you okay?
I'm sorry, Papa. Just need some alone time.
Buddy, I think we have to talk. Buddy, I think there's something I probably should tell you. You should have found out a long time ago. I then proceeded to tell Buddy of how his father had fallen in love when he was very young with a beautiful girl named Susan Wells, and how Buddy was born and put up for adoption by his mother, and how she had later passed away. I told him his father had never even known that Buddy was born, and most importantly, I told him where his father was, in a magical land called New York City.
My dad works there?
Empire State Building.